Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, surely the deen, the way of life, which people call the religion, but the much better word is a way of life, is with Allah is only al-Islam. And Islam meaning is submitting to the will of Allah. Or in other words, you are promising to Allah that all my life, O Allah, I follow your commandments. That is the meaning of Islam. If you are willing to do that, and if you are doing that, then you are a Muslim. But if you are only follow the commandments of Allah inside the masjid only, and not outside, then you are masjid Muslim, but outside you are not Muslim. You could be only Muslim 24 hours when you are willing to obey the commandments of Allah 24 hours a day. Then you are a Muslim 24 hours a day. Because that's the definition of Muslim. Aslim. Aslim means that I am willing to follow the commandments of Allah all my life. That's the definition of Islam. So religion is with Allah is that you are willing to follow the commandments of Allah all your life. Ano sabihin ng Islam? Na isang tao gusto niya sumunod sa lahat ng utos ng Allah sa buong buhay niya. Yan sabi sa yan sabihin Muslim. That is the meaning of Islam. Whoever is following the command, sino mang sumunod sa utos ng Allah, mga utos ng Allah, siya ang tinatawag Muslim. At Islam, na yung religion na bigyan ng utos ng Allah, and you have to follow those commands of Allah, then you are Muslim. You are following the Islam. And those who follow the Islam, they are Muslims. Three messages, because Allah said that if anybody choose any other religion other than the Islam, he will be the loser. Logi, sarana pagukum. And also in this world, he will be a loser. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ الْغَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا فَلَا يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Very clear. If you are not willing to submit to the commands of Allah, the Islam, then Allah said you are a loser. Logika, saro na pagkukum. You will go to hellfire. Whoever choose any other religion other than Islam, that submitting to the will of Allah, to the commands of Allah, then Allah will not accept from him. And on the day of judgment, he will be among the losers. Sino man nang tanggap ng relihiyon maliban sa Islam na sumunod sa utos ng Allah. Hindi tanggap ng Allah at sa araw ng paghukom, siya ng katalunan. He will be loser. So what is Islam? Believe in one God. Worship only one God. Believe in the messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last messenger and last prophet of Allah. Believe in all the prophets of Allah from Adam alayhi salam until the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all the prophets to believe. To believe in the angels of Allah, that angels of Allah are created by Allah from the light. And the belief in the books of Allah, which was given to all the prophets, like Torah, the Zabur, the Injil, and the last book, the Quran. And believe in the day of judgment, and believe in and believes in the paradise, and to believe in the Qadr. Qadr, lahat na nangyari sa atin by the will of Allah. Everything happened to us, good or evil, all happened to us by the will of Allah, and Allah already written for us. When you will die, what you will eat, where you will have your sustenance, where you will born, where you will marry, everything is written by Allah in advance by his knowledge. And only those things will happen. That's Qadr. And of course, it's written because of his knowledge, that he knows what we are going to choose. Are we going to choose as a believer, or are we going to choose as a disbeliever? Are we making a wrong decision or right decision? Allah knows. He knows what we are going to do. He predict that. And he write that everything for us. That's Qadr. And what we should do? Pray five times a day. Fast in the month of Ramadan. Give the charity if you are rich to the poor. Go to the Hajj once in your lifetime. But the very, very important is the one what I said in the first khutbah. Do not cheat people, do not lie to people, and do not discriminate to the people. White is not better than black, and the black is not better than the white. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that. The Arab is not better than the non-Arab, and the non-Arab is not better than the Arab. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that. Marano is not better than the Tausuk, and the Tausuk is not better than the Marano. That is the meaning of Islam. Do not discriminate people. Do not cheat people. Do not lie people. Because these are the three messages for today. If anybody is committing these three messages, the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ declared that he is not a Muslim, he is not a believer. He said, "Man khana falaysa minna," whoever cheat, he is not among us. If you sell the pirated things, you are cheating people. And the Prophet said, you are not a Muslim, you are not a believer, you are not among us. So what you see, when you see a Muslim selling the pirated things, he is actually a pirated Muslim, not original Muslim. Because he sells pirated things. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said he's not a Muslim. Because he cheat people. Sino man loko sa tao, hindi siya Muslim, sabi ni Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Whoever lie, he is not among us. Prophet said that a believer, can he be a bakhil, the niggard, kuripot? A Muslim, a believer, he can be a coward, juban, or in Tagalog, duwag. Sabi ni Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, a believer, he cannot be a liar. Sabi ni Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, yung pananampalatay, hindi pwede siya ng sinuwaling. A believer, a Muslim, cannot be a liar. You sell the people the things, this is original. But it's not original, this is fake. You cheat people, you lie to people. And the Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, you are not a Muslim, you are not a believer. If somebody say I am wrong, then he can challenge that, what the Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. Challenge what the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. Can you go in a war with the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam? Allah will destroy you. And I will add one more thing here. All the Muslim worlds today, how we can blame to the non-Muslims? All the Muslim worlds, every Muslim country in the world today is cursed by Allah. Because every Muslim country today is dealing with riba, the interest, the usury, lending the money on the interest. How they will be not in the curse when Allah said in the Quran, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu taqullaha wadharu ma baqiya minar riba in kuntum mu'minin. Oh, you who believe, if you fear Allah, then give up the riba, give up the usury, give up the interest. If you are believers, fa in lam taf'alu, so if you will not do it, you will not give up, you still deal with the bank with lending money, borrowing money, paying the interest, discounting the check. Fa in lam taf'alu fa'adhanu biharbi min Allahi wa rasuli. Take the notice of the war from Allah and His Messenger. Take the announcement of the war with Allah and His Messenger. Can you think that Allah and His Messenger is making a war with you? Then you are blessed? You have a mercy from Allah? No, only the curse of Allah upon the people who are dealing in the riba. So I was supposed to give the three message. I add one more. There's too much for us in the whole week to follow this. No lying to people. Wag na sinuwaling. No cheating to people. Wag na loko-loko. And do not discriminate. If anybody you see, don't think that you're better than him, or your race is better than him, your language is better than him, or your nation is better than him. No. Do not discriminate, because all the people in the world are equal. All are the children of Adam and Hawa. All the human are brothers and sisters in humanity. And we have a much more greater brotherhood, is the brotherhood in Allah. Brotherhood in Islam. Because Allah said in the Quran, innamal mu'minuna ikhwa. Those who are believers in Allah, they are brothers. They are brothers and sisters. What is the biggest relation can you have with any human being? It's the relation of Allah. That he believes in Allah and I believe in Allah. That's the biggest relation. Nothing bigger than that. The biggest relation that we can have in the world today is a relation because of Allah. That you believe in Allah and he believe in Allah. You believe in Allah and she believe in Allah. That's the biggest relation. Value that relation. If anybody say La ilaha illallah, don't fight with him. Don't hate him. Don't be hatred with him. Love that person because he say La ilaha illallah. He believes in Allah. He stop making this discrimination, this fitna, Sunni Shia and Deobandi and Salafi and Wahhabi and Ash'ari. Stop this all. Stop it. Don't call yourself with those names. Call yourself a Muslim. I'm a mu'min, I'm a believer. And if you believe in Allah, then you're my brother. If you say La ilaha illallah, you're my brother. Stop all these divisions among the Muslims. No Sunni, no Shia. No Wahhabi, no Salafi, no Ash'ari, no Hanafi, no Shafi, no Maliki, no Hanbali, nothing. Bury them all. No value the Arab or Chinese Muslim or American Muslim or Pakistani Muslim, no value. The value, you are Muslim. Now, no value for American or Chinese or Indian or Arab or Maranao, no value for all this. What is valuable? I am a Muslim and you are Muslim. Regardless of your race, regardless of your language, regardless of your nation, regardless of your geographical location, I don't mind anything. If you say La ilaha illallah and I say La ilaha illallah, we have a brotherhood. Innamal mu'minuna ikhwa. So in my khutbah here, so remember my advice here. Follow that advice and propagate that advice until the next Jummah. Don't lie. Wakkasinu waling. Wakka logo logo. Don't cheat people. And do not discriminate people. Because Allah Prophet said, if you are doing these three, according to the Prophet saying, you are not a believer. And I add one more. Allah said in the Quran, if you are dealing in the riba, lending money on interest, borrowing money on interest, then you are making, you have a warrant from Allah and His Messenger. So your salah, your zakat, your fasting, everything useless, because Allah is making a war with you. So we have to think of this all very seriously and to put in our lives and to propagate to the people of the world. May Allah guide us, may Allah save us.
Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to share, like, subscribe, and comment.